Hello learners, welcome to Environmental Science course of Foreign Senior Secondary, Level in IOS. I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of Environmental Science. Welcome you in this program. We have already given you an idea about environmental pollution, their sources and ill effects in lesson 10 of module 4. Environmental pollution as a topic of which we should all be aware because it directly disturbs our health and well-being. Now we will discuss lesson 11. Environment and health of module 4. During this program, we will discuss how the deteriorating environment can affect our health and well-being. The objective for this lesson are list and describe problems of sanitation and habitation, differentiate between different modes of spreading, waterborne diseases caused by pathogens, vectors and chemical pollutants, list certain waterborne diseases, how they spread and the consequences thereof, discuss various pollutants in agriculture, cottage and large industries in mining areas with respect of environment and health, define cancer, cite examples of environmental carcinogens and methods for their control. I will be talking about how our health is being affected by the deteriorating environmental conditions. We all know that health is physical, mental and social well-being of a person. Environmental health is the study of how environmental factors can harm human health. It encompasses the assessment and control of those environmental factors that can potentially affect health. It is targeted towards preventing diseases and creating health supportive environment. Promoting public health in the 21st century is a multidisciplinary endeavor ranging from the surveillance of health and disease in populations to the provision of health advice and information. It occurs at all levels, from the action taken by individuals to those taken by national and international agencies. It also takes place in many different settings, for example, in homes, workplace, schools, hospitals, youth centers, nightclubs, and on the streets. Health is the result of interaction of a large number of influences upon a person. For example, genetic influence, behavioral influence, and environmental influence as shown in the flowchart. What is genetic influence? Genetic determines the physical and physiological characteristics of an organism. We all know that hereditary diseases are passed on from parents to offspring. Diseases like allergies, hypertension, diabetes, etc. are not entirely genetic. However, they are due to the interaction of genes with the environment. These are triggered and affected by nutrition, stress, emotion, hormones, drugs and other environmental interactions. What do you mean by behavioral influence? Alcoholism, smoking, use of drugs, tobacco chewing or irregular food habits causing various kinds of health problems is behavior influence. Last one is environmental influence. Various components of the environment exert their influence on our health. These can be grouped under physical, chemical, biological, sociological and psychological factors. Besides this, sanitation and other problems in habitation are a real cause of concern. Worldwide, 2.4 billion people do not have access to basic sanitation and lack safe means of disposal of excreta and waste water. Despite continued efforts to promote sanitation, 40% of the world population is still without basic sanitation. This number does not tell the whole story. Sanitation coverage is often much lower in rural areas than in urban areas. In many cases, improving sanitation can be as simple as installing a well-designed ventilated improved pit latrine or composting latrine. However, in other cases, improving sanitation will be more challenging, particularly in rapidly growing urban slums. Sanitation facilities interrupt the transmission of fecal-oral diseases by preventing human fecal contamination of water and soil. Poor waste disposal practices are responsible for a significant proportion of the world's infectious diseases. Diseases due to poor water supply, sanitation, personal and domestic hygiene cause of all deaths and roughly about 5.7% of all disability or ill health in the world. However, when basic water, sanitation and hygiene interventions are applied, waterborne illnesses can be effectively reduced. As you seen in the image, unregulated growth of habitation, lack of proper toilets, especially in villages, towns and slum areas of cities, does not permit proper disposal of human waste, which in turn leads to improper sanitary conditions and health hazards. Improper drainage results in the accumulation of wastewater in public places, in villages, towns and cities. Animal excreta and movement of cattle in and out of water pools and puddles spreads this filth over larger areas, further causing sanitary problems. Scarcity of clean drinking water, contamination of food and poor personal hygiene are the major cause for the spread of many waterborne diseases. Let us now discuss the sanitation problems faced by the people of rural India. Rural India faces sanitation problems beyond Western imagination. With its 1.25 billion inhabitants, nearly 800 million people in the country live without basic sanitation. Due to a major lack of toilets, some 600 million people of India are forced to defecate in the open. India's sanitation problem is most of all a problem for the nation's female population. Open defecation not only spread diseases like cholera or entamoeba and contaminates unprotected water sources, but also exposes women to the risk of being harassed or raped when they rise at night or before dawn in search of a little privacy to attend to their toiletry needs in the field. Furthermore, women and girls in rural India have limited access to feminine hygiene products as well as day-to-day challenge of where to dispose of their makeshift pets. So the problem faced by rural people are lack of safe drinking water supply, lack of proper drainage lead to contamination of groundwater and other sources of drinking water, ignorance of sanitation and hygiene, improper ventilation in rural households, improper disposal of excreta, etc. The sanitation problem faced by the people of Indian cities: no sewer, no clean water, no sanitation, no electricity. In cities, lack of proper drainage, improper roads, free roaming of animals on roads and their excreta are a cause of concern. Improper roads and different types of transport pollute the environment and are the major cause of health problems. Now, come to the cities. You will be surprised to know that about 1/5 of the urban population resides in slums and 1/3 of the population does not even have access to sanitation and clean drinking water, which results in poor health. These are all consequences of rapid urbanization in India. In city slums, unplanned aggregation of hutment arranged very closely without any space for roads, parks, drains, etc., with no proper ventilation and cooking on wood, burning chulas have been a cause of respiratory and other health problems. Lack of proper drainage, unavailability of clean drinking water add to the health hazards of these city slum dwellers. Now, cities industrial area. Many industries are established in unplanned manner and without environmental impact assessment, which has resulted in air, water, soil and noise pollution. Dear learners, we have already discussed the undesirable consequences of industrialization in lesson 10, module 4 of environmental science course. There is environmental health issues are no less in residential come commercial areas. Those of you who live in a city or have visited a city must have seen commercial activities in areas meant exclusively for residential purposes. Since these are unplanned, there is no proper infrastructure for these commercial activities in residential areas. City residential areas and commercial areas contain lot of overcrowding, haphazard parking, lot of noise, garbage dumping, burning of tree leaves and plant residues. All this has not only increased the pollution level, it has also been a cause of concern from the health sector point of view. The chaotic city traffic has also been a source of many health problems faced by the people of Indian cities. City traffic are a cause of concern for the people of cities of India. I am sure now it must be clear to you that whether we live in rural areas or in cities, in slums or in town, we are constantly facing health problems. Do you know that at least 1/5 of the world population lacks access to safe drinking water? In developing countries, 80-90% of the untreated sewage is discharged directly into rivers and streams. I am sure all are aware that water from rivers and streams is used for drinking, washing and bathing. If this water is not properly treated before put into use, then it is a very big threat to public health. Polluted water is the breeding ground for a large number of pathogenic organisms. These pathogenic organisms can cause various gastrointestinal problems, liver infection, cancer, etc. Large number of children die because of diarrhea. Eye diseases such as trachoma and conjunctivitis too can be spread by contaminated water. Surface flow in river represents 97% available water, but rivers are polluted due to untreated sewage, industrial waste, etc. So, instead of being a boon, these rivers are proving to be a threat to human health. River Yamuna becomes highly polluted after entering Delhi due to the addition of untreated sewage, industrial waste and many other pollutants. The important question is, how can the waterborne diseases spread in humans? It can be spread by drinking contaminated water, using untreated water for personal hygiene, for washing food and other items, washing clothes. Waterborne diseases can also be spread by parasites living in water. You can see the various waterborne diseases caused by bacteria, virus, protozoans, helminths, and also vector-borne diseases related with water, their causative agents and symptoms in the tabular form in next few slides. First, this slide shows typhoid and cholera, their causal organisms, mode of spread and symptoms. Typhoid, cholera, diarrhea and leptospirosis are the bacterial diseases. Infective hepatitis is a viral disease. Amoebic dysentery is a protozoan disease as shown in this figure. Bilharzia, Guinea worms are the helminth diseases, and malaria, filaria and dengue are the vector-borne diseases as shown in next slide. It is not only water, but environmental health hazards are also due to air pollution, agriculture, mining industries and increasing urban settlement have all contributed in increasing the pollutant in the air and thus posing an ever-increasing threat to our health, not only in India, but throughout the world. We have discussed about air pollution, different types of air pollution, pollutant and their ill effects on plants and animals in lesson 10, module 4 of environmental science. We have learned earlier about air pollutant and we know that they can be found in air anywhere, outdoor or indoor. As you are aware of the term criteria air pollutant, learners, well, it is term used to describe air pollutant that have been regulated and are used as indicator of air quality. The regulations or standards of these pollutants are based on criteria that related to health or environmental effects. 6 criteria for air pollutant in outdoor air or ambient air are carbon dioxide, lead, nitrogen dioxide, ozone, sulfur dioxide and suspended particles, as shown in this figure. Our country's economy to be a large extent is dependent on the agricultural sector, but at the same time, agriculture is posing a threat to our health because of increased use of pesticides, fumigants and fertilizers. We need to use them judiciously and also regulate their use. Overuse of fertilizers, solid or liquid, causes soil bacteria to produce excess quantity of nitrous oxide. Pesticides and fumigants such as methyl bromide are added to field. These toxic substances escape as gases or as particulate matter that is carried by wind. Many studies have examined the effect of pesticides exposure on the risk of cancer like leukemia, lymphoma, brain, kidney, breast, prostate, pancreas, lung, liver and skin. This increased risk occurs with both residential and occupational exposure. Increased rates of cancer have been found among farm workers who apply these chemicals. A mother's occupational exposure to pesticides during pregnancy is associated with an increase in her child's risk of leukemia and brain cancer. Exposure to insecticides within the home and herbicides outside is associated with blood cancers in children. Due to the persistent nature of the residue of these pesticides in the environment, the danger is increased because of chronic exposure to low level of pesticides. Asthma and other respiratory diseases can be caused due to continuous exposure of these pesticides. Asthma is a chronic lung disease with recurrent obstructions of airflow, particularly at night and early morning. The obstruction is reversible either spontaneously or with therapy. It involves difficulty in breathing due to inflammation, mucus in the airways, and tightening of the muscles around the airways. The changes to the airways that occurs in asthma, you can see the changes taking place in asthma in the airways in that image. Muscles contract and tighten up. Inflammation of the airways takes place. The passage for the air to pass through narrows in asthma. Asthma can cause shortness of breath, pale and sweaty face, tightness or in chest, blue lips, tightness in neck muscles, choking sensation, difficulty in talking, anxiousness, severe bruising, spasmodic cough, rapid breathing. These are the asthma symptoms. Pesticides contribute to disease like asthma and other respiratory problems, system failure, skin problems, birth defect, nervous system disorders, cancer, loss of ability to learn, general poor health, kidney, liver or other organ diseases, premature death. Burning of biomass waste from agriculture produces ammonia, nitrogen oxides, methane, carbon dioxide and smoke. Toxic gases are also released from the use of machinery such as diesel, pump, tractor, etc. Tractors and other farm machineries use petroleum. These equipments often lack of emission control devices that are required on automobiles. All this is adding on to our health problems and need to be taken care of. Modern agriculture use a lot of nitrogenous fertilizers and manures. This leads to increased levels of nitrate in the ground, as nitrates being soluble in water easily leach into the soil. When large amount of nitrates in water are ingested by an infant, it is converted to nitrite by the intestinal bacteria. The nitrite then reacts with oxyhemoglobin to form methemoglobin, which inhibits the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. If a large amount of methemoglobin is formed in the blood, body tissue may be deprived of oxygen, causing the infant to develop a blue coloration of their mucous membrane. This condition is known as methemoglobinemia. Digestive and respiratory problems may also be because of consumption of nitrate to water. The majority of cases have occurred when nitrate level have been over 100 milligram per liter. Low oxygen level in the blood cause the lips, fingers and toes to look blue, as seen in this figure. Due to reduced carrying capacity for oxygen, the babies gradually acquire a blue tinge, and hence the name blue baby disease. Affected infants may become irritable or lethargic. Depending on the severity of condition, the condition can progress rapidly to cause coma or death if it is not recognized and treated appropriately. Nitrates can be removed from the water by processes like electrodialysis and reverse osmosis. Nitrates in the water can be oxidized to nitrates by introducing a strong oxidant like ozone in the water. In modern livestock facilities, the high density of animals result in the emission of large quantity of methane and other small hydrocarbons, hydrogen sulfide and ammonia. Approximately 37% of human-induced methane production comes from livestock. As already discussed in Lesson 10, Module 4 of Environmental Science, serious ecological implications and health risks are also associated with industrial air pollution. Fast depleting ozone layer and its implication on human health has been discussed in detail in Lesson 10, Part 1. Greenhouse effect, which is another important ecological problem, too, has been discussed at length in the same lesson. Another much talked about ecological threat is global warming, which is largely considered as one of the most hazardous and serious complications associated with air pollution caused by industries. The liberation of certain gases, such as methane and carbon dioxide, together known as greenhouse gases, is often considered to be the prime factor causing global warming. Why is global warming is a threat to the society all around the world? This is because global warming results in the melting of glaciers and snow caps, mountains, resulting in an increase in the water level, of seas and rivers, eventually increasing the risk of floods. Apart from this, global warming also often has numerous serious health risks on humans, such as increase in disease like Lyme, malaria, cholera, dengue and plague, among others. Another important environmental threat from industries is acid rain. Industries and emit large amounts of nitrogen and sulfur gases into the Earth's atmosphere. When these gases react with water vapors in the atmosphere, they often change into more aggressive gases, namely nitric acid and sulfuric acid, respectively. The rain containing large amount of these acids is known as acid rain. Acid rain causes serious health problems such as cancer, skin disorder, and even health. Apart from health hazard, acid rains results in the erosion of monuments and buildings, makes the soil acidic in nature, resulting in reduction of plants and animal growth, among other issues. Dear learners, you may recall the emission of various gases and their ill effects on human health and plant life from lesson 10 of module 4. Look at the figure. Besides agriculture industries, mining is too a major cause of concern. Mining is a process wherein minerals below the earth are extracted using large equipment. During this process, dust and chemicals are released in the air, causing massive air pollution. Mining operations like drilling, blasting, hauling, collection and transportation are the major sources of emissions causing air pollution. Coal left on the ground can catch fire, and mine fires are difficult to control, with some burning for decades or even centuries, creating a major source of air pollution. The use of explosives, such as in mountaintop removal, releases carbon monoxide. Dust and coal particles stirred up during the mining process, as well as soot releasing during coal transport, contributes to emissions and respiratory problems. Asbestos mining contains asbestos dust, which causes asbestosis. Silica causes silicosis. Lead, zinc, and other heavy metals such as chromium, arsenic, copper, and manganese, and radon gas may also accumulate in high concentrations in their respective mines. High level of alpha and gamma radiation can also be found in and around uranium mines and uranium ore tailings. You can see the figure. It is estimated that more than 1 billion people are exposed to outdoor air pollution annually. Urban air pollution is linked to up to 1 million premature deaths every year. Rapid urbanization has resulted in increasing air pollution in major cities, especially in developing countries. Over 90% of air pollution in cities in these countries is attributed to vehicle emission brought about by high number of older vehicles, coupled with poor vehicle maintenance, inadequate infrastructure, and low fuel quality. You can see two pictures in this slide. Let us also study some other aspect of environmental health hazard. One such environmental health hazards are the carcinogens present in the environment. What are carcinogens? Carcinogens are cancer-producing cells in living tissues. Learners, do you know what is cancer? Let me explain. Normal cells divide in an orderly way. They die when they are born out or damaged, and new cells take their place. Cancer is when the cells started to grow out of control. The cancer cells keep on dividing and making new cells even when new cells are not required. They crowd out normal cells and form a mass of tissues called tumor. You can see different types of tumors. Cancer cells can spread to other parts of the body. Some cancers grow and spread fast. Others grow more slowly. Tumors can be either benign or malignant. Benign tumor is not harmful. Tumors that stay in one spot and demonstrate limited growth are generally considered to be benign. Generally, it can be removed surgically and does not reappear. Further, cells from these tumors do not move to other parts of the body and rarely endanger life. On the other hand, malignant tumor is cancerous. Cells of these tumors are abnormal and they divide and redivide without any control. They may invade and damage nearby tissues and organs. Cells from these tumors can break away and enter the bloodstream or lymphatic system and spread from the original site to form new tumors in other organs. Most cancers are named after the organ concern. Example, cancer that begins in lung is lung cancer, and is the one is skin is known as melanoma. Leukemia and lymphoma are cancers which are initiated in blood-forming cells. The World Health Organization estimated that worldwide there were 14 million new cancer cases and 8.2 million cancer-related deaths in 2012. They are most recent data. So the learners, this is all about environment and health, part 1 of lesson 11. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points once again, that is what you have learned. Environmental pollution may adversely affect the health and well-being of humans. Lack of clean drinking water, unhygienic conditions, and pollution of the environment in villages, towns, and cities are responsible for spread of diseases and large number of health problems. Many waterborne diseases such as cholera, infective hepatitis, dysentery and diarrhea, bilharzia and malaria are transmitted by different ways. The mixing of untreated or improperly treated sewage and river cause extensive water pollution and related adverse health effects. Major air pollutants in agriculture areas are ammonia, methane and pesticides. In cottage industries and industrial areas, they are smoke, carbon dioxide and oxides of sulfur. In mines, such as coal mines, the workers exposed to coal dust for a long time suffer from black lung disease. Presence of high nitrate concentration in drinking water often causes methemoglobinemia or blue baby disease in bottle fat infants. The nitrites produced from nitrates bind with hemoglobin to form methemoglobin, which inhibits oxygen transport in the body. At times, cells in certain parts of the body keep on dividing even though not required. These cells become cancerous and form malignant tumors. So the learners, this is all about environment and health, part 1 of lesson 11. We would like to meet you with a new program of environmental science again. Thank you.